Communicatie is die wisseling van boodskappe tussen mense. Dis wanneer gedagtes, gevoelens of inligting geruil word. In hierdie video gaan ons kyk na mense wat 'n belangrike rol in communicatie gespeel het. Communication is the act of giving, receiving and sharing information. Like talking, writing, listening and reading. The following people played an important role in communication long ago. Helen Keller is in 1880 in Alabama in Amerika gebore. Op die ouderdom van 19 maanden het sy doofstom en blind geword as gevolg van 'n baie ernstige siekte. Dink net hoe moeilik dit vir haar moes gewees het om nie te kon sien of hoor nie. Omdat haar ouers haar so jammer gekry het, het hulle haar alles toegelaat en sy het in 'n ongemaneerde verwarde kind ontaard. Met behulp van haar onderwijzer Ann Sullivan het hulle begin suksesvol kommunikeer na 'n lang gesukkel. Die deurbraak het gekom toe Ann vir Helen na 'n waterpomp gebring het en terwyl sy water oor Helen se hand laat loop het, het sy die woord water in die palm van haar hand uitgespel. Helen het toe besef dat elke voorwerp 'n naam het. Helen Adams Keller was born as a healthy child in Alabama in 1880. At the age of 19 months, Helen became deaf and blind as a result of an unknown illness. As Helen grew older, she became wild and unruly. Nobody understood her as she couldn't communicate. Remember, she couldn't see or hear. Her life changed in 1887 when she met her teacher, Ann Sullivan. It was the beginning of a nearly 50-year-long relationship. Ann Sullivan began to teach Helen to communicate by spelling words into her hand. At first, Helen was frustrated because she didn't understand that every object had a word, but eventually had a breakthrough when she learned what water is. Helen was also able to have strong connection with animals through touch. What a remarkable woman! Alexander Graham Bell was 'n Skotse wetenskaplike en uitvinder wat in Amerika gewoon het. Hy en sy tegnikus Thomas Watson het heeltemal toevallig 'n deurbraak gemaak. Dit was in 1875 wat die eerste klank bloot toevallig gehoor is. Bell was in 'n kamer en het 'n draad probeer losmaak. Watson het 'n trilling in 'n ander kamer gehoor en besef dit wat hy gehoor het was die eerste kommunikasie oor 'n draad. Alexander Graham Bell was a Scottish-born inventor, scientist and engineer. He is best known for inventing the first working telephone in 1876. His partner's name was Thomas Watson. Louis Braille was die Franse uitvinder van 'n lees- en skryfstelsel vir blindes. Sy stelsel van kolletjies het wêreldwyd bekend geword as Braille. Hy het in albei oë blind geword na 'n ongeluk in sy kinderjare. Hy het toe 'n kodestelsel ontwikkel wat blinde mense in staat gestel het om vinnig en doeltreffend te kan lees en skryf. Louis Braille is the creator of Braille, a code that enables blind and visually impaired people to read and write independently. Because of an accident, his eye got infected and spread to his other eye. By the time he was 5 years old, Louis was completely blind in both eyes. He learned of night writing, a tactile communication system devised, used in the army so soldiers could read at night. Louis Braille simplified this night writing so it could be more user-friendly for the blind. Samuel Morse was 'n Amerikaanse uitvinder en is bekend vir sy ontwerp van die telegraaf en Morsekode. Dit is oor die hele aardpol gebruik. Dis 'n stelsel van kolletjies en streepies waarmee die telegraaf werk. Met sy uitvinding het hy 'n groot fortuin verdien. Samuel Morse was an American inventor. He and his friend, Alfred Weil developed the Morse code. Before telephones were invented, it could send messages over long distances by using pulses of electricity to signal a machine to make marks on a moving paper tape. A code was necessary to help translate the marks on the paper tape into readable text messages. Morse developed the first version of this code.